What's going on, everyone? Welcome, Rabbit here, and Clore AI has been getting a lot of chatter lately, and I'm going to show you how to mine it. So why would you want to mine Clore AI in the first place? Number one, it is GPU mineable. A lot of you guys out there just love them GPUs. So if we go back to the 1 year here, this coin was actually under half a cent. That is right, less than half a cent here. And fast forward to now, we're upwards of 23 cents, almost 24 cents here. That is a 5,879% gain. On the past 1 month, that's 673% alone. And the past 24 hours, we're still up. I guess it just went down a little bit to 3%. So in order to mine this coin, just like every single other coin, you're going to need a wallet. If you head on over to Clore.ai, simply click on wallet at the top here, scroll down a little bit once it finally loads. Here we go. And then you will see your various wallets. So we got the Windows wallet, the Linux wallet. You can see the source code. They also have a partnered wallet here. This guy right here. But myself, I recommend the Windows wallet or Linux if that's what you want to do. And that's your normal core type of wallet that you see with Raptorium, early Bitcoin, everything out there. Just download that, get your address, and you're ready to go. So I do have this wallet on a little node box, so it is kind of glitched at the moment, but that's okay. In order to get your wallet, simply click on the receive here. Then you'll go to your label, name this whatever you want. Here I'll go test video. And then simply request payment. From this point, this is your address right here. So just copy this address, and that's what you're gonna use to mine to. So we're gonna start this off in Windows, and I'm gonna try Gminer for this. I do have an NVIDIA card, the RTX 3090. If you're running AMD, you will wanna go with Team Red Miner. So in this case, head on over there if you got NVIDIA and download the latest Windows Gminer version. There's lots of different miners that does support Kapow. There's Wild Rig, there's BZ Miner, T-Rex Miner as well. You can try them out if you want. All the basic setups are pretty close to the same thing, minus the config file. So download this, and once you do extract that, you'll come up to something like this. Now scroll down to all the pre-configged AutoExec bat files here, and then you'll see Ravencoin, Neri AI, Neoxa. These all run off Kapow, so it's just fine. It doesn't have Clore in here by default, so I'm simply going to right click on Raven, copy this, and then paste it in. So I'm going to go like that. Then I'm just going to rename this one over to Mine Clore in big capital letters so I can find it easier. So we're going to do that. And then once you find that, we're going to scroll up to Clore here, right click and edit it. So now this is all the parameters we got to adjust. So right here, user, this is our wallet address, which we just got with our wallet earlier. This is our pool address, which we will be utilizing Hero Miners, because Hero Miners is the sponsor of today's video. Elgo is Kapow. This is where Kapow, where Ravencoin and everything didn't matter because it's all on the same algorithm. All right, so the first thing we're gonna do is copy our address in here. I got all my addresses in one single notepad, so it's easy for me to just swap things over and whatnot if I need to on certain rigs or something. So just copy that in, just use the wallet address copy command that you saw earlier, and then we're just gonna paste this in like so. Like that, and then we're going to put period. I'm going to go RabbitWS for our username. So right here you can see, here's our wallet address followed by a period, then RabbitWS. This will be whatever you want to name your rig, and that'll show up on the pool so you can kind of track each individual miner. Now in this case, now we got to find our pool address, and that's this guy right here. And we're going to head on over to Hero Miners. Here we are on the Hero Miners dashboard. Simply choose the closest stratum that is to your location. In my case, I'm in Western Canada. We're going to rock Western USA. So I'm going to copy this, right click it, copy it. Then we're going to go back into our bat file here, erase that, and paste this in. That is it. We are now done setting up our config file. So I'm just gonna go to file and save. I'm not setting any type of overclock settings within the mining software itself because I do like to use the LOL GUI to do that when I'm in Windows. So if you don't have a newer version of LOL Miner, I recommend downloading it. And this is how I do my overclocks in Windows. So you can see LOL Miner GUI here. So right click this, run as administrator. You need administrator privileges to set any type of overclocking in Windows. So now I'm just gonna bring up my afterburner just so you can kind of see what's going on. So I'm gonna set my core clock here to 1400. We're gonna go core offset of, I guess, you know, we'll just do 200 or something. And our memory clock, I'm just gonna go 1000. Just, you know, some rough numbers here. Now I'm gonna apply the OC. So watch afterburner here, it'll apply all that. Bam, and now you can see we're at 1410, 5001. A little bit more than what it should be, but regardless, it's still going to work. So now we're going to come into here, go back to GPUs. We're going to find Gminer and find our Clore config right there. Double click on it, and we are now up in mining in Windows. Now, if we go back in the pool, scroll down to the bottom here, enter your address. I'm just going to paste that in. We'll look it up, and then we'll see if we have any hash rate detected. And yes, so we're already detected here at the pool. The test bench about an hour ago. That's weird. Okay, I guess I had that on for a second too. I totally forgot about that. But right now our workstation is up and running. So everything's looking good. We're mining Clore AI to the Hero Miner's mining pool. Let's run on over to Hive OS and see how to set that up. Okay, so here we are in Hive OS. The first thing you are gonna wanna do is click on your wallets here and add wallet. We gotta get our wallet added into the Hive OS database for our rig. So we're gonna click coin and ticker here. Simply type Clore and it'll pop up here, and then put in your wallet address, paste that in right here. Mine is a bunch of gobbledygookers here, and then name it whatever you want. Wallet name, it'll be called whatever the heck you do name it right here. Next up, you're gonna click on flight sheets up here, coin in the ticker. We're gonna type in Clore again. This time the wallet we just set up will be defaulted here. This is my core wallet, which is what I do have mine named. And then pool, Hero Miners is not yet added into Hive OS as default. So we're gonna configure this into the miner. Now we're gonna need a wallet name. So I'm just gonna go Clore test video. And then we're gonna pick our miner. In this case, we're gonna go with Gminer again. And Gminer does work for NVIDIA, but Team Red Miner is probably the go-to when it comes to NVIDIA GPUs. So we're gonna hit Gminer here and set up miner config. It already has Kapow in here. If it doesn't, simply click on it and then find Kapow in the list. Now we need our wallet and worker. So just click on here. That'll add your wallet, which is pulling your wallet data as well as your rig worker name straight into the flight sheet itself. And now we gotta add our pool. So we simply go back into Hero Miners over here. And now we're gonna see USA West. We're gonna choose the same closest stratum as we did in our Windows version. Pick the closest stratum where you live. Go back into Hive OS here and simply paste that into the pool server. Now here, the port goes in a different location. So we're actually gonna cut this one out, or just remember it and delete it, and then put that in the port here and paste it in. That is it. That is all we need to do. Next up, we're simply gonna hit apply changes and then create that flight sheet. Choose the rig that you want. In this case, I did scroll down to test bench and it has no flight sheet loaded. You can set some overclock settings in here. Now, again, this is an RTX 3070 now. I'm just gonna lock the core at 1400. Memory, I did go to 2500 here. In Hive OS, you do use double what you would use in Windows. I did only use 1,000 Windows, so in theory for the same memory, if it was the same GPU, I would need to use 2,000. But here, I'm going with 2,500, and I did set a power limit of about 150. Once you set whatever you want, simply hit apply here, and then go to flight sheets, and scroll down to that latest flight sheet, Clore here, and then send that one to the moon. That should now start your rig up and mining Clore AI to Hero Miners in Hive OS. So once that flight sheet is loaded up and the miner's running, wait a few minutes and we should start seeing hash rate. I'm at 28.8 mega hash. Do a refresh here, 28.86. So I'm getting anywhere from 28.86 upwards to about 29.5 or so, depending on your overclock settings. You know, obviously you do a lot more tweaking here for this algorithm based on the GPU that you have. Now we're gonna go back into the pool here and it looks like our rig is detected. I'm just gonna do a quick look up again, make sure everything's up to date. And yeah, our test bench is online. We are sending shares, the pool is seeing them. So everything's looking good. We are now mining in Hive OS as well. So hopefully this does help you out in getting set up for Clore AI in both Windows and Hive OS. I will see you on the next one. Rabbit out.